What's up, everybody? This is episode 3. I'm in Cabo. This beautiful, beautiful home at a bachelor party with an amazing group of guys who really helped put this weekend into such a beautiful place. And I'm here to give you like a good update. This has been an amazing week. Last week I had to close out leasing out my mom's house, getting rid of all of her stuff, and filling up and kind of just doing a few loose ends, and those are done. And after that hard work, I got to launch and do some great stuff with work, actual my business, and had an incredibly, incredibly productive day, productive week. I launched our tie-dye shoes, so these handmade custom snibs that are like really cool and beautiful and really special. And we thought they were incredible at the company, and we sold out. We sold out of most of the sizes within 24 hours, had our most productive non-sale day since we launched the company a year ago, and really, really crushed it. And it was just so fun to see that we were able to launch something successfully like that, update the website, do all of this hard work, and just be able to actually crush it, like literally sell out of the shoe. Then I also had another great thing happen this week, and Hatch, my Japanese restaurant downtown, had its like most productive week ever. I mean, 2 sale days in a row that were insane. And that's incredibly inspiring. I mean, a restaurant, it's COVID, things are starting to loosen up, things are starting to get better. And so even like my catering business is still catching up, my food truck, TLT, everything is starting to go on the up and up. And so for this week, I'm excited to talk about growth and things starting to feel like maybe they're normalizing a little bit more. I mean, yeah, I'm in Mexico. I'm in a beautiful place. This definitely helps, but the businesses are starting to catch on fire. And now it's really about how I act. I mean, one of the things I said was in 60 days, my whole life is going to change, but that's not just like my whole life is going to change and I don't have anything to do. If I take that success and squander it, it's nothing, right? You know, and so this time I really need to make sure that we're successful and that we know what we're doing and that we're able to actually make this a sustainable growth. And so that's what this next week's gonna be all about. I mean, we're raising money for Snibs so that we're well-funded. We have a great team. And raising money is one of those things that I absolutely adore. Most entrepreneurs hate it because it's distracting and it's difficult. But you get to talk to a bunch of really smart people about what they find important in your business, you know, and they always have unique questions. And that's because they believe that those unique questions create value. And so it's about perspective when you raise money, but I would suggest looking at it a little bit differently, because if you can find great people and have a lot of fun with it, and for the people that didn't work out, learn what they were looking for, learn what you didn't like about them so you can kind of avoid it going forward, and start to A/B test fundraising, which is something that if you're a serial entrepreneur, you're going to be doing a lot. You'll start to love it, and you'll start to build a community and a network and friends that start off as investors, and now you get to talk to them consistently. And so I'm incredibly excited about this part of the business and the fact that we're doing that right now. And then what comes next is like Hatch. We got to look for a second location. We got to learn how to be profitable. We got to upgrade and update the menu, because it's been about a year since we've done a nice overhaul on that menu. And so that's really exciting. TLT and the Lime Truck, same thing. I mean, it's time to do a little bit of a last minute kind of sweep before the show airs to make sure everything is on the up and up. Launch this taco box that I've been working on tirelessly for the last 5 months, that gives you to-go tacos that aren't soggy. And so as excited as I am and as well as things are going, and now that I'm saying them out loud, I have a laundry list of goals that are gonna be very intense this quarter, and you get to follow along as we do them, but each one is gonna be a major project and really, really impactful on my business. But anyways, I just wanted to share that the tone this week is significantly better. I'm feeling so good. I mean, I'm feeling motivated. I know there's a crazy amount of work ahead of me, but I feel like things are getting better. And if you're there, you know, and you're kind of dealing with similar things, go outside, start to take a walk. I mean, being out here in nature has been hugely impactful on me feeling better. Being with friends has hugely impacted me feeling better. And then also just noticing that we are starting to go back to normal. And as we go back to normal, things are going to get better, I feel like. I mean, you know, things are going to change, but businesses are looking better. I mean, I'm literally up so much this week over last week. And again, the same thing happened 2 weeks ago. So I'm feeling like things are going to get a lot better for you entrepreneurs out there that have had COVID really affect your business. And yeah, let us know that the hard work's ahead, but it doesn't mean that it's impossible. And it felt like maybe like that like 3-4 months ago. So I'm excited for everybody. Shout out. Hopefully you're going to be getting some of this, you know, benefit as well, and that you're on the up and up. And if you're not, just know that with hard work and a little bit more time, I think we'll get there together. All right. Cheers, guys. Bye.